Right, so this is about the SilkNow image analysis or image processing tool. So we have all of these pieces of information about silk fabrics in the records coming from museums, but sometimes the annotations in the museum are incomplete. So which other source of information can we tap under these circumstances? Well, we always have images of these silk fabrics, and perhaps we can actually learn something from the images. Perhaps given an image of a silk fabric, we can answer questions such as, when was this fabric produced? Or in terms of machine learning, we want to predict the variable production time span, or which materials were used for this fabric, or we could predict the variable material, and so on and so forth. So what we have is a set of images with known annotations. So for these images, we know, in this case, the time, the place, and the technique that were used to produce these fabrics. For some of these images, we know all of this information. So we know the true values of all of these variables, the two right ones, the two left ones. For some of them, well, we actually know, we may only know one or two of these fields. The other two fields may be unknown. We can use these images with known annotations to actually learn what images of fabrics that were produced in a specific time or in a specific place look like. The technique that's used for that purpose is a convolutional neural network. That's, a network that consists of a series of mathematical operations that are applied to an input image. The name ResNet 152 tells you that there are 152 such operations, so it's a very deep architecture. And at the end, we get a feature vector, a vector that represents the properties of this image to the machine. And from this vector, well, the machine actually predicts. In this case, it predicts three variables, the production time, the production place, and the production technique. And for this specific example, well, this would have been produced in the second half of the 19th century. It was produced in Catalonia, and it was produced using the technique Jacquard. Now, how can we train this? Well, at training time, we use images where we know the output. We pass these images through the network. The network will predict something. Then we compare this to the known values. If they are identical, then everything is fine. If they're not identical, we compute the so-called loss function, and then we try to change the parameters of the network such that it becomes more and more probable that the prediction is the true one. So we have tested this using samples from one museum, from IMATEC. And here what we see are accuracies, so the percentage of correct predictions for three different variables: production time span, production place, production techniques. We have two different variants. The first one, based on the orange bars, here we considered all training samples, also samples where some of the annotations were unknown. We refer to these samples as incomplete samples. The blue bars refer to the result we get when, well, we only use samples where all of the properties were known. And we see if we use, well, these complete samples where we know all properties, we achieve accuracies over 90%. If we also use incomplete samples, we achieve somewhat lower accuracies, but we are still well above 85% in all cases. So why should we use the incomplete samples as well? Well, some classes only occur in incomplete samples, so the set of classes we can differentiate is larger if we use also incomplete samples. This comes at the cost of a slightly worse performance.